Hello and welcome to my retro gaming zone. I'm Tomaniac and tonight I show you the family computer with 600 built-in classic games. As you've noticed, this is a Famiclone system, but it comes with HDMI 720p output. And this is a really interesting device which I bought from the Wicked Gamer and Collector. And I met him at the last retro fair at Nordweikerhout. It was very nice to meet you and to talk to you. And kind greetings from Switzerland, man. Yeah, and I show you the box from all the sides. There we have HDMI output, 600 built-in games, family computer. And the same is here on this side, and nothing on the bottom. And on the other side, we have some blah 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 in Chinese. And again, HDMI, 600 built-in games, and the picture. So the next thing I show you is what was in this box. And the first thing I noticed was this gaming list, and it has over 600, and there seem to be some really nice games on this device. And what I noticed is that there are many, many, many different games, and it's a big diversity, and perhaps there might be some homebrews or hacks, and these are the games I will especially look for, because I really find them very interesting, and I like to try them out. But there are also some really great games on this list. And I hope they are also on this device. And we will go through this list later so that you can see this better. On the left side, we have the English and on the right, the Chinese version. And it also came with this manual, but to me, it's rather useless because I don't understand Chinese, and the English version is not really that better. This is the manual. Then we have the power supply. The power supply is with a micro USB and comes with this adapter. The problem here in Switzerland is that this adapter doesn't fit into a Swiss socket. So I had to buy myself an Swiss adapter. And I didn't try this one out. I have a similar one. And so with this one, it sits quite tight. It should do the job, and I will try this out later. Then it also came with an HDMI cable. And this is a really cool thing. Not every device comes with an HDMI cable. And here we have one. Oh. It also came with these composite cables for AV out and audio left and right. And as you will see soon, the console has different outputs. It might be that you have to use this, though you have the HDMI signal. I will come to this later. So. Then next we have this the controllers that belong to the system, and they have this 9-pin connector. It seems to be a standard of all these clone consoles that came from China, and the controller is rather tiny, but the buttons feel quite good. And we have everything you need here, the D-pad. The D-pad feels very well and not mushy or something. It's really a responsive or a good feel, like the original. And the buttons also feel very well. And yeah, it seems very well built, very well made. Now, it doesn't feel like cheap plastic. So yeah, quite good. I like this. I really like the design. And yeah, cool thingy. And then we have our main actor here, the cool baby Famiclone device. And as you can see, this is rather tiny, but it fits really well, and it's really well built, I think. Yeah, and yeah, I really like it. Like the design. It's light, but it feels sturdy. And here we have the power and the reset button. And here on the front we have the 9-pin connectors. And yeah, you can put your controller here at the side, and yeah, it holds really good. And then you have the outputs here, and on the back you have everything for the video signal. Here we have the power supply connection, is micro USB, then audio left and right, and the AV output, and here we have the HDMI output. And yeah, there's something to say, because when I first connected this to my flat screen via HDMI, I had the problem that there was no sound. There was only the picture. And I don't know why this is, but you can solve the problem if you have similar problems when you buy this one or have this one and don't know what to do when you only have the picture. Then you can use the cables for audio left and right and connect the end. You can use an adapter, for example. I have an adapter from Chinch to the yeah, you know what I mean, I think. Yeah, so you can connect this with your speakers or sound bar or TV or whatsoever, and then everything works fine. You have the HDMI output, and you have the audio then from this ones. The strange thing is when I connect the HDMI with my capture card and the output from the capture card into my TV, then I have sound. Then everything works fine without problems. I don't know why this is, and it doesn't seem to be a problem of my TV. So don't know why, but when I connect this with my capture card, HDMI only, then I have both. Then I have sound, and then I have picture. And yeah, it should be 720p. As you will see next when I connect this to my TV, is that the picture is 16 by 9. And there is no possibility to change it to 4x3, for example. And I tried to change this via my TV, but whatever I want to set there, there's no chance. It's always stretched to 16 by 9. The only way I could get this to 4x3 is to let this run through my FrameMeister, and then at my FrameMeister I can say make this one 4x3. For me this isn't a real problem, because yeah, when I want to make videos from this, then later on I can correct this to 4x3 via my video Magic's Video Maker program, and then this shouldn't be a problem. And yeah, I don't connect this to my FrameMeister right now, because I want to show you what you will see when you connect this one to your TV. And yeah, so I will change my position. I will go to my flat screen and connect everything, and then I will show you some footage. So, see you soon.
So, here I'm back again, and as I promised, I connected this little device via HDMI with my capture card, and when you turn on this little machine, then you can choose between two languages, Chinese or English, and I will choose English because I don't understand Chinese. Hit the start button. And this is what you see when you open this menu the first time. And I will go into this menu and we will see which games are in these lists. Mario, so we have different Mario games here. Mario Bros. 2, 3, Mario 10, 14, 16. This is rather strange. So, I think there are many hacks on this. Hacks or homebrew games. And later on we will test some of them out. Then we have different Contra games and hacks and so on. Super Contra 7, 8, Robotector, Final Mission. Isolated Warrior is a rather good game. I have the original cartridge for my NES. Shatterhand, another really great game. I don't think that this is a hack of something, so we will test out this later. Hot Blood, Basketball, High School, Ice Hockey, March, Soccer, Story. Of which games does this remind me? I don't get the name right now. So then we have different turtle games. Turtle Fighter. Turtles 1, 2, 3. So we will look at these later. What I have planned is to do some videos of the games and will show different game once, so perhaps I will do a video, a longer video of Turtle 1 for example. And so here we have Adventure Island games from 1 to 4, and the most interesting part is this list. Oh, what's that? The first time this happens. Okay, I hope this is so back again. Don't know what happened here, that everything freezes up. So I wanted to show you this 545 in 1. And I'd like to go through this list so that you can see which games are on there. And I just skipped through the list so you can read this. What's a bit sad is that some of the texts are chopped off on the right side. And what you also can see here is that the picture is stretched to 16x9, and there's no possibility to get this to 4x3. Perhaps you have luck and your TV supports 4x3 and you can switch it to that. My TV doesn't, and so I have 16x9. The only way I can put this to 4x3 is to let this run through my FrameMeister, and then I can change to 4x3. So yes, I wanted to go through this list so that you can see what's on there. Just skip this. You can press pause when you like to read this more exactly. Parodius. Oh, very well. Roadrunner, Pocket Monster, Roller Games, Secret Time, Silkworm. There are some games I like to try out. Smash TV, wow, if this is real, then it's great. Super Turrican. So, there seem to be some very nice games here on this list, and I definitely have to try some of them out. And yeah, I think I will do more videos of these games from this little console, clone console. Klex? Oh, cool. Don't know what Klex looks like on the NES or Famicom, because this is a Famicom device, so most of them are Famicom games, I think. Oh, Arkanoid, cool. Yeah, there might be some games that didn't come out in the PAL region. Urai Fighter, very nice. So, yeah, I recognize some really good games here on this list. And yeah, we are half the way through. Flappy. Golden Bird, Gold Castle. So yes, there also seem to be many Hype Light. Oh, I have bought the cartridge recently. Kung Fu. Is this the Kung Fu Master version? Then it's really great. It's nearly arcade perfect. Nachrider. Okay, I know this. I have this. Mighty Bomb Jack. Oh, really cool. Normally it's yeah, a game that's hard to get and that's rather expensive in the PAL region. Miss Pac-Man. Very cool. Pac-Man. Yeah. Quarth. Oh, I have to try some of these. Definitely out. Yeah. So, I think you get tons of games, and yes. So, yeah. You have to plan much spare time for this. Galaxian. Golf. Ice Climber. Hyper Sports. Okay. IQ Champion. Karateka. Karateka. Nice. Yeah, what I'm looking for is Gyrus. A really nice space shooter. But as far as I know, this didn't come out in Europe. It was a US release only, as far as I know. So I think it's not on this list. Yeah, Gold Fighter. Space Invaders! Tactful Surface, Firestar, Starfighter, Triple Jump, Tennis, Teletubbies. Witzy! GR Kung Fu! Okay, so yeah, why not try this one out? Yeah, I will start it and then we will see how this works and how the controllers work, if they are spot on. Okay, let's start. Push start. Select level 1 or 2. Demo. So, with the select button you can select the level as normal, and with start, I guess, yeah, you start. Yeah, Kung Fu, and now we will see. Okay, so what I first recognize is that the control is spot on. There's no really noticeable input lag. I think it's rather directly. Yes. The pad works really well, though it's rather tiny, but it's okay in my hands. It's, yeah. You have to get a bit used to it, but then it's not bad, and yeah, it seems to work. Duk. Yeah, I finished him, but it was close. So as you can see, this seems to work. Wow, oh, come, let's try another round. Jack. And then I will load another game and we will see what we have there. Perhaps something that yeah, seems to be a hack or or a homebrew version of something. Nah. Really cool that this is on the list. I don't have the cartridge. What I have is a multi-cartridge. Perhaps there we have the game also on this list. And normally, or in future, I plan to play these NES and Famicom games via my AVS from Retro USB. But what I can say is the output quality is quite nice, quite sharp. Though it's stretched to 16:9, but I have no problems with that when playing this here in front of my TV. Yeah, it works properly. And okay, this should be it for the moment. Hope I can reset this without bigger problems. So, okay. Yes, I will load another one and we will test it then. So, let's try out one of these Mario games. For example, what is Yoshi Hash Cookie? Let's get into it. I don't know. A surprise bag. Hash Cookie. One player or versus. Weed. Hash Cookie, license from Bulletproof Software. Okay, this sounds strange. Push start, low, mid, high. Round 1, speed, medium, music type A or B. Yeah, I let this as it is and I push start. I want to see what we have here. Hash Cookie. Ah, look at this border. Oh my gosh. Push start. What? What do we have to do here? I don't know. Ah, we can switch this. And then... Ah, when you get 4 in a row? Ah. Ah, then it vanishes. Okay, so, oh, Mario looks rather tired. This is interesting somehow. Aha. So, at last you have to get two of a kind. Okay. This is weird. But somehow interesting. So that was easy. And now? Don't know, but... Ah, there something comes. And... Ah, can we switch this? No. Don't know how to switch this. Okay, so... It works. Yeah. I think we try another one. So, let's see another one. So, next, I would say we try a Contra game. What about Contra Force? I don't know what this is. We will see soon. Contra Force, push start button. Neo City 1992. The phone rings. Hi, it's me, Fox. Is that you, Burns? Yeah, and so on and so on. Start button. I want to lose up now. Here, come. Let's take Burns. And burn with Burns. So this is Burns. And this is Contra something. Okay, so. You can shoot with the B button and jump with A. And otherwise... So this is okay. I have to learn the controls. I don't know if this runs as it's supposed to be. So can I choose between different weapons or such? No. Okay, when pressing pause, then we can change between the chars also. Command select, yeah, it seems so. But you can cannot select between different weapons, as it seems. Okay. Die. At last, at least it seems playable. And I haven't heard of this game before. Well, and yeah, this shouldn't be a wonder because I don't know many of the games because I just bought the system recently. Yeah, let's press end here and try another game. Push start button. No, I push the reset button on this little clone console device. And let's see what we also have here. Yeah, next we see here I have started the game out of this Hot Blood series, and yes, this seems seems to be a game from this Neketsu, I think, Neketsu Games, something like that. So this is all written in Japanese or Chinese, so I don't understand what's written there, but I hope you can also you can find out what to do though. I don't know what they say, and so this is a bit difficult for me to, yeah, just choose. Yeah, what can we choose here? Don't know if this is good or not. Ah, yeah. So remove set. Yeah, I think we will lose now. okay. But it looks nice. I don't know how to pass. How do I pass? So it looks rather nice, and yeah, it's playable, and it works. Bash! Yeah, and yes, I shoot a goal. Yeah, great. So this works. And now, ah yes, okay. So you can also control the goalie. When the when the enemy is near, so dash. Still, I don't know how to pass or to select how to select my closest player. Oh. Okay, so that's enough for the moment. So yeah, I would say we try a last one. Yeah, I would say I will show you Turtles or Adventure later. Yeah, okay. And we go into this list. Yeah, I definitely will do some more videos from this device and show you some more games. Well, this just should give you a little impression of what we have here. Oh, King of Fighters 99. Street Fighter 2010. So, yes. Now I wonder what we have here. Let's start this and, yeah. Street Fighter 2010. Okay. So what is this? Is this a homebrew? A little background. Okay. So, it's mixed up English and Japanese, as it seems. So, that's really interesting. Not. Target versus Kevin. So you don't, you cannot choose between different characters. And what is this? So this doesn't look like a beat 'em up. It more looks like a platform game. What is this? Okay, it's interesting, so to say. Ah, you can climb up the walls. But I don't hit anything and got hit and died. Okay, now this is weird. Was this a game you could buy back in the days, or do I have a homebrew here? Does any one of you know more about this? Oh, this is... Oh, this is hard. No chance here. And the problem is I don't know where to go. And what you can do and what not. Okay, so I think there are many more rather interesting games on this, and I definitely will try them out. All of them! So this will take lots of time. Yeah, you will see many videos on my channel. Okay, not all from this console, but from many others, from the Atari 2600, or the Commodore 64, or the Amiga, or the GameCube, or the Mega Drive, PlayStation, Master System, PlayStation 2, and so on and so on. And yeah, I hope you stay tuned. And I hope you like this little video. So my final conclusion to this is, it's a really nice little clone console, which has lots and lots and lots of games, so it doesn't get boring. And yeah, it's well built, the quality is rather good, I think. It's sturdy, it doesn't feel like cheap plastic, and the controls are rather good. The buttons feel well, and the D-pad feels well also, and the emulation is rather directly. There's no really noticeable input lag. The picture quality is rather crisp. We have a 720p output, and if you don't have any problems with this stretched 16:9, then this console is definitely worth buying. And yeah, I thank the Wicked Gamer and Collector for this nice device. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if so, feel free to give a thumb up, or or to subscribe to my channel. And yeah, see you later. Bye, folks.